So if you work on presentations, you know that one of the challenges is getting good graphics to go with the words. So when you're putting together a presentation like this one, you need to find something to go here, right? A picture. So you may look through clip art collections and all sorts of things. Well, one of the things that you can use, but a lot of people don't realize, is GIFs, or GIFs if you prefer. Of course, these animated little graphics are now used throughout messaging and Facebook and everything, and people use them to respond to things with emotion. And you can find plenty of free stuff online. A lot of people don't know you can drag and drop those into Keynote and use them. So let's go ahead and take a look here. I'm going to go look at the site Giphy or Jiffy, which is just basically a huge archive of all sorts of different GIFs, and you could just search for things. So just like with searching any clip art collection, you can of course search for something that fits what you are talking about. So this is talking about planning your best route for traffic. So let's search for traffic. So actually Traffic Jam here, a search, brings all sorts of images up, and we could basically just drag and drop any one of these that looks good into it. And let's go ahead and use this one here, and I'm going to drag it, and you can drag it right into the little placeholder here. Now that I've got it in there, I can go to the format sidebar here, go to movie, and I could set some things. I could set it to loop. I could set it to start movie on click or not. I can have a loop back and forth or continuous or not loop at all. I can also trim it. So if there's something at the beginning, the end I don't want to see, I can cut that out without having to edit the video. So when I play this, you can see since I didn't have it set to click, it just plays automatically. So I get a nice animated graphic. Now the legality of using the graphics you find online, that's a whole other story. But I'm going to assume that you're going to take care of that or use public domain things. Or maybe you're just presenting this for fun and you don't care about the legalities of it. So let's go and look at some others. So you don't have to have the placeholder there at all. You can just have a blank slide like that and it will still work. So let's go back to Safari here, and I have another tab where I did a search for sleep. So you can find something cute here having to do with sleep. That's a good one right there. So let me go into that. There's that image. I can drag that in, and that inserts just fine as well. I can scale it up a little bit to fit, and maybe this will be just don't repeat and just start right away. So when you get to this slide, you just get this, and then it freezes on the last frame. And I can even customize the last frame if I want by trimming here. And then here's a last one here. We can go in and say if you search for paperwork, you know, you can grab a animated GIF that's got some fun paperwork stuff. There we go. That's a good one. And you can drag that into this area as well. So it's really easy to be able to use animated GIFs in your presentations. They certainly add a lot more flair. A lot of people just don't realize that you can use them. So go ahead and drag and drop and place them inside, and they just appear these cool videos that you can now work with inside of Keynote.